Hey, what's up, everyone? Adam here with Probably Got This, and today we are back with the updated PvE Magicka DPS Ice Warden build. Ice and magic damage build, I should say. But this build is extremely fun. This was the Defrost build before. I'm not calling the Defrost build this time because this is a little bit different. You can still use some of the same things, but it is different and it's exciting. But this build is so easy to use. It's very simple. It's beginner friendly and it provides great sustain. It provides heals. It provides great damage. And it's something I think for a lot of beginners and even middle of the road players, I think will really enjoy this build. Before we get started, I do want to mention thank you so much for all the patrons. If you would like to become a patron, you get early access to every video and much more perks. Check out the link below in the description. And you can join us live on twitch.tv/probablygotthis. You can join our Discord. You can follow me on Twitter. And you can go to our website, which has these builds in written form. We're currently updating all of them on the website and getting them on the website. But you can check that out at probablygotthis.com. But let's go ahead and jump into the video. So if you haven't seen my original Warden PvE Magicka DPS build, I will link that in the description. But with this one, we have some exciting new changes that I'm very, very pumped to use. And so what we normally do is we go through all the different categories, stats, skills, rotation, champion points, all that stuff. All of those timestamps will be in the description. If you do skip, though, you will miss important information, especially if you haven't seen the previous video. So make sure to watch each section. But if you do like this, make sure to like, subscribe, and heavy attack that bell icon. It really helps the channel and it helps you stay up to date on when I release new content. So let's go into the stats and the race and the moonness and the food. So the race, we're using Breton, of course. Breton is amazing for PvE, Magicka DPS. I love it. 64 points into Magicka. This is all unbuffed. So we're using 32K into max mag. We have 32K into max Magicka. 21.4k max health, and we actually have 3,111 spell damage and 43.6% spell critical, and 8761 spell penetration. Now, for the food, we're using the Longfin Pasty with Melon Sauce, and for the Moonstone, we're actually using the Apprentice, okay? This is going to increase our spell damage, and the reason we're doing this instead of the crit stones is because so we have item sets that are actually tapping into spell damage. So I wanted to kind of play onto that and actually utilize the spell damage scaling. So we are Apprentice Moonstone, and that is what we're looking like there. So let's go into the skills now. So the skills haven't really changed at all, but I do have some alternates that you can use because I was playing around with some different things, and I want to mention those to you for different situations and just if what your preference is, because I did like some of them, but for me, I kind of stuck with the same thing. So this build is meant to be extremely, extremely easy to use. It's supposed to be very beginner friendly, and it's just something that you should be able to utilize and output a decent amount of DPS with ease. So I made this rotation as simple as I could. So the first bar is our Wall of Elements. This is a Frost Staff because again, we are a Warden. So I wanna use the Ice damage. Now if you choose to use an Inferno Staff, your DPS will go up some, but I'm using the Ice Staff just so we can get that full effect. So this is just the Destruction Staff skill right here. Second skill is Inner Light. This is a slottable skill. You do not need to use this skill. What this is going to do is basically just give us max Magicka by five. It's gonna give us 5% increase to max Magicka and give us a spell critical bump from Major Prophecy. It's just fantastic. Veteran Infection is a key part of this build. It's something that you start your minor buffs with. This does a lot of damage over time, magic damage over time. And this is going to apply minor vulnerability, which is going to help with one of our sets that we're wearing. So this is in the Animal Companion line, third skill. Fourth skill, which you always need to have up, is Blue Betty. Blue Betty is going to restore Magicka to you over 25 seconds, and it's going to give you Major Brutality and Sorcery, increasing your weapon and spell damage by 20%. You want to have this up all the time. Don't let this run out. Second skill is another slottable. You can use it for a speed boost, but it's another slottable. This is Bird of Prey, the last skill in Animal Companion. This is going to give you Minor Berserk when it's slotted, increasing your damage done by 5%. It's fantastic. And we are still using the Bear Ultimate, okay? Eternal Guardian. This is going to deal 2706 magic damage, and it's going to deal 10,827 magic damage and stunning them for 2 seconds. Once summoned, you can activate this for 75 ultimate, causing the bear to maul an enemy for 12,243 magic damage, deals 100% more damage to enemies below 25% health. So you want to make sure to use this in your execute phase. Now you need to have this on both bars or it will despawn. Now, The alternate ultimates you can use Permafrost, which is going to be a nice little frost damaging ability. I love this one. And you could also, there's two other ones you could use. You can use the Elemental Rage Destruction Staff ultimate, or you could use the Mage's Guild Ice Comet ultimate, which I really think is fun as well. So these ultimates can be interchanged, whichever your preference is. I like using the Guardian, though. It just does a lot of damage. Now, on the main bar, we have, again, our main spammable, which is Screaming Cliff Racer. Screaming Cliff Racer is amazing. It's going to deal 7870 magic damage. If you're more than 7 meters away from the target, you set them off balance for 7 seconds. And it deals up to 15% more damage based on how far away the enemy is. So the farther away you are, the more damage you're going to do. So I'll show you in the rotation. We're actually going to be staying kind of close for some of the sets that we're wearing. So you can switch this out with Winter's Embrace skill, Arctic Blast, if you want. This is going to do damage over time. It's also going to heal you. And it's a really, really nice skill for the Warden. But I'm using this because I love the spammable. I think it's fantastic. And again, it's just something that you can interchange out if you'd like. You can also change it out with Pulsar. I really like Pulsar because Pulsar does a nice bit of magic damage to the enemy. I wanted to try to use Destructive Clinch, but that would taunt the enemy, so we cannot use that with an Ice Staff. But I really did like this one as well. But I would prefer, if you were going to switch it out, to switch it with Arctic Blast. And if you're playing solo, this is really nice to keep a heal up as well. So again, you can switch that with Screaming Cliff Racer if you would like to. Second skill is Deep Fissure. This is a nice damaging skill. Deep Fissure deals 11,806 magic damage to enemies in front of you after 3 seconds. Enemies afflicted with major breach, reducing their physical and spell resistance by 5948 for 6 seconds. It's a fantastic skill. This applies a debuff and it does a crap ton of damage. We are double barring Inner Light and Bird of Prey. Again, these are just flat buffs, Minor Berserk, and it gives us Max Magicka and Major Prophecy. The last skill here is Winter's Revenge. This is from the Winter's Embrace line. This is a AoE that you can lay down. It's going to deal frost damage, and it's going to reduce the movement speed of your enemies by 30% for 3 seconds, and this has a higher chance to apply the Chilled Status effect, which is really, really nice for reasons once we get to the sets. Again, we got Eternal Guardian for the ultimate. Now, for the passives, we want every single Winter's Embrace passive. The one that's really important is Piercing Cold. Increases your magic and frost damage by 10%. This is going to just give you such a nice boost. This is I love this passive for the Warden. Green Balance, you really don't need any of the passives. You can get them, though, if you have extra skill points, but you really don't need them. Animal Companion, you can get every single one of these. Make sure to get every single one because, again, you're going to be doing 8% more damage because you have four Animal Companion abilities slotted on this bar right now, okay? So 8% more damage on this bar. And then Flourish is going to be really nice for Sustain. Savage Beast is really nice as well. And this is also going to heal you anytime one of your Animal Companion skills end. So whenever we do one of these, you're going to heal, which is really fantastic. For the weapon, you're going to get every single Destruction Staff passive that you can get. For armor, you want to get all the Light Armor passives. Your Mage's Guild, you want to make sure you get Magicka Controller. For the Fighter's Guild, you want to make sure you get Banish the Wicked. And for the Undaunted, you want to make sure you get these two passives here. For Racial, you want to make sure you have all the Breton passives. They're fantastic. It's really good for our Magicka character here, so make sure to get these passives as well. Okay, let's go into the sets. So we have two new sets that we're running with this build. You can still run the older sets if you would like. I just have really liked the ones here that we have. The set that has not changed is Icy Conjurer. Icy Conjurer is from Frostvault Dungeon. You do not have to have this on the weapons and jewelry. You can do it on the body pieces, whichever you want to do for each of these items is really up to you. But I have it on the jewelry and I have it on two weapons. You can switch this last weapon out with the Maelstrom Ice Staff. I do like having that. Or a Staff of Willpower. This is just here though. And so what this set does is it adds Max Magicka, Spell Damage, Spell Penetration, and applying a minor debuff to your enemy summons a non-reflectable Ice Wraith that will charge into your enemy doing 13,740 frost damage over 10 seconds. This effect can occur every 10 seconds and scales off the higher of your weapon or spell damage. So this is really nice because, again, the Fetcher Infection that we're running, Fetcher Infection is going to start this off for us right here. This is going to apply a minor debuff immediately. So this is going to be one of the first things you use on your rotation, which we will get to in a second. But what that does is that lasts for 10 seconds. So by the time you get back to your next bar, that skill lasts 10 seconds. And so you're going to be able to do that every 10 seconds. And you're going to keep that ice wraith up all the time. Now, for the enchants and traits, I'm doing Max Magicka. You can do Bloodthirsty. And for the enchants, I'm doing Magicka Recovery. For the weapons, I'm using Precise. For the Maelstrom Staff, you could use Infused if you would like. But that is really up to you with these. You do not need gold jewelry as well. So as you can see, when we're buffed, we're actually at 20,385 frost damage with Icy Conjure because we are actually trying to tap into that spell damage because our other set is actually increasing our spell damage as well. And with our Moondustone, the Apprentice, giving us spell damage as well and us slotting that for CP, which we haven't gotten to yet, this is going to increase the damage that Icy Conjure is going to do because, again, it's scaling off your spell damage and not your spell crit. Now, I know spell crit is really good, and I know a lot of people run spell crit, but I wanted to try to use spell damage on this because I wanted to try something different. And so, as you see, as we're buffed, this is increased to 20.385 frost damage, and I think that can go even higher. So I really like this for the Icy Conjure set. Now, our newest set is Sash of Frostbite or Frostbite. This is a new set from Blackwood, a zone set, so it's very easy to farm, okay? Very, very easy to farm. And this is going to be really, really nice for the Ice Warden because, again, let's see what it does. Add spell damage, spell critical, and it increases your damage done with frost abilities by 8%, increases your damage done against chilled enemies by 4%, increases your damage done against enemies afflicted with minor brittle by 2%. So we're getting those nice buffs for our Ice Warden build. I love this. I love this set. It's now one of my favorite sets in the game because I just love how it augments ice builds for us. I love it. And it's very easy to farm in Blackwood. You can do overland content to get this. You can buy it from guild traders. I have divines on all of it. I have Max Magicka enchants. Again, you can switch this into the weapons and jewelry and switch Icy Conjurer to the body pieces. It does not have to be how I have it here, but I love this. Now, we're using Ice Heart now. So before we were using like Falcon Scoria and Domi House. You can still use those helms. They're not bad. But Ice Heart is actually something that I really like. It is something that I've seen. I've seen people tell me, they're like, yo, Ice Heart's actually doing pretty solid right now. And I put it on. I was like, holy crap, this is actually doing pretty good. And it just fits our ice build and our ice theme. And so this is kind of what I was talking about before with the Cliff Racer spammable. We need to kind of be in a close proximity with this just because, again, we got to be within 5 meters. So if you don't want to run the Cliff Racer and you want to run like the Whirlwind Ice Attack, you can do that as well. But what this does is add spell critical. And when you deal critical damage, you have a 20% chance to gain a damage shield that absorbs 5,000 damage for 6 seconds. While the damage shield holds, you deal 1389 frost damage to all enemies within 5 meters of you every 1 second. This effect can occur once every 6 seconds, and the damage scales off your higher of your weapon or spell damage. So again, this scales off of spell damage, so we're trying to tap into that a little bit. This is Divines and Max Magicka Enchant. We're using Light and Light. You can use Medium and Heavy if you want, but this is Light. For these, okay? So, again, you can still use Domi House and Falcon Scory, but this is base game, and this is Blackwood and a DLC dungeon here. But I love these item sets. I think it's really, really fun, in my opinion. And so, now what we're going to do is we're going to go into the champion points and then the rotation. Okay, so for CP, what we are doing for the blue tree, a little bit different here. We got 20 into Eldritch Insight. We got 20 into Precision. We got all this here. Again, you can do a 40 into Flawless Ritual, 30 into War Mage, 20 into Piercing, and 40 into Battle Master. You don't need 40 and 30 here. This is just because I had extra points. But this allows us to get to this. We need 50, 50, and 50. Thaumaturge, Deadly Aim, Biting Aura. Slot all three of those. The other thing we're slotting is Wrathful Strikes. This grants 33 weapon and spell damage to your damaging abilities per stage. So we have 165 weapon and spell damage since we are going on spell damage. We are not using Finding Finesse because we are building for spell damage, not spell crit. Okay, so this gets slotted as well. For the red tree, we got 50 into Survival Instincts, 20 into Heroes, 50 into Mystic Tenacity. We got 50 into Siphoning Spells, 50 Ironclad, 50 Rejuvenation. It's the same thing, basically. Slot Siphoning Spells, Survival Instincts, Rejuvenation, and 15 Ironclad. Green is really up to you. Okay, let's go through the rotation now. The rotation is literally so simple, okay? So simple. All right, so what you're gonna do is, again, I'll go through slow and then I'll speed it up a little bit for you all so you can see a little bit more of a real time. But what you do is, the first thing you wanna make sure you have is your Betty up. So get your Betty up, okay? You're gonna go Fetcher Infection, Light Attack. See, there goes the Ice Wraith. You're gonna use your Wall of Elements, Switch Bars. So let's do it again. Betty, Light Attack, Fetcher Infection, Light Attack, Wall of Elements, Switch Bars. Okay, make sure your Bear is also up as well. Okay, so that's what you do on the first bar. Now, when you're on the second bar, what you do, make sure you stand close enough for Ice Heart. Second bar, you go Winner's Revenge, Light Attack, Deep Fissure, Light Attack. And as you see Deep Fissure, watch. Deep Fissure comes up after 3 seconds. So just keep that in mind, okay? So what you can do with Deep Fissure, which is really nice, is you can cast it and you can switch your bars. So I'll get to that here in a second. But as you see, it still goes off. So let's go back. So Winner's Revenge, Light Attack, Deep Fissure, Light Attack, Cliff Racer, Light Attack, Cliff Racer, Light Attack, Cliff Racer, Light Attack, Cliff Racer, Light Attack. Now, depending on how good you are at weaving your Light Attacks in, you should be able to get at least 3 to 4 Cliff Racers in. And then before you switch bars, you want to go Deep Fissure again, switch bars. So then you just rinse and repeat, okay? Your Betty is still going to be up, so you won't need to reapply that yet, but you need to make sure you have Fetcher Infection and then Wall of Elements, switch bars, okay? Now, you want to also make sure that you are always using your ultimate with the Bear as well. It comes up very quickly because it's 75 ultimate. It's very, very, very quick, okay? So let's speed up a little bit so you guys can see what that looks like. So Betty, Fetcher Infection, Wall of Elements, Winner's Revenge, Fissure, Cliff Racer, Cliff Racer, Cliff Racer, Cliff Racer, Deep Fissure, Fetcher, Wall of Elements, Switch, Fissure, Cliff Racer, Cliff Racer, Cliff Racer, Cliff Racer, Switch, Fetcher, Wall of Elements. And then on the second rotation, you're going to put your Betty up again. So basically, you'll do that twice around, and then your Betty will be ready for another application. So again, I'm gonna go through this fast, and you guys are gonna be able to see what it's about. Okay, so here we go. So as you can see, this rotation is very, very simple. It's very easy to use and it's fun. Again, you get to do that like RP ice effect plus magic damage. And I really like the new sets that come with this. I love Frostbite and I like using Ice Heart as well. And again, our crit is up to around 49 to 50% when we're buffed. So you're gonna be getting that proc a lot of times. So you shouldn't have to worry about that. But again, we are specking into spell damage, but that is the rotation. If you have any questions about that, let me know down in the comments below. But again, this is on the website. We're going to be updating this here soon, but it is already on the website. But real quick, we're going to go into the fashion because we always do that. Now, we kind of look like an ice plague doctor, which I kind of like, but we are using literally True Sworn motif on every single piece of armor here. So I absolutely love this style. We're also using the True Sworn staff here. And the dye that we're using is Blackreach Blue, which is unlocked by doing the Savior of Western Skyrim achievement. So very, very easy to get. It's not too hard to get. But yeah, this is our fashion here. I love it. It's like we're chilled and we're icy. But yeah, that is the fashion and that is the build, y'all. That is the updated Ice Warden PvE DPS build for Blackwood. I do hope you all enjoy this. I hope that is something that you guys will use and try out. Let me know down in the comments if you do. Let me know in my Twitch chat if you do. Again, you can find all those links below in the description. But just remember to have faith, be great, and I'll see you on ESO.